can hear the explosions going off at most, if not all, of these homes back in here. Absolutely nothing they could do.
That right there is my home. I've lived in this log cabin for 18 years with my family, and about a month ago, it all burned down from one of the California fires.
Tell me when it's too late for forgiveness. If I apologize in the
mirror, guys, it's just the saddest thing. You know, my physical childhood from where I've grown up my whole life, I mean, it's just gone. It went up in flames about a month ago, and you're probably watching this and you're like, holy shit, like, this happened to you. And yeah, it was probably one of the scariest days of my life, one of the saddest. I'll get into the story in a couple minutes, but I mean, we lost like everything. Right now I'm at my grandma's house. She lives in a retirement community, and we're kind of just all stuck in like two little rooms right over there. Myself, my mom, my twin little brothers, and a couple dogs. But yeah, I mean, before I get into it, I want to quickly say, you know, how thankful I am to really get out of there, because it was nuts. I mean, we only had about a minute, and I mean, we're one of the lucky ones, because there were a lot of our neighbors who, they couldn't grab anything. You know, our next door neighbor literally ran out with only her underclothes, couldn't grab any of her old pictures and all her antiques. You know, all that's gone. House is up in flames. And you know, other neighbors that we had who were trapped and literally had to get an escort out of the area. So it's just really sad, and we're lucky to be alive. So this setup is really unprofessional. It's literally just a couple boxes and my camera, because that's really all I was able to grab. But yeah, I'll tell you guys what happened. If anything, I just want to let you guys know, like, this gives me a lot of motivation for like myself and for my family. You know, we're gonna get out of this stronger. I'm gonna, you know, be working my ass off in life to just, you know, do something great. And so that's kind of how I look at this. You know, I don't really want to focus too much on the bad and just look towards the future. There's a lot to look forward to, and things are only gonna get better. So I'll tell you guys the story. This is what happened. I live in this little town called Winters. We're like 5 miles out in the country. So we get fires all the time. You know, it's nothing uncommon. In the last couple years, it's been like a monthly occurrence, especially like during the summer. But we never really thought it could get to us, because we're so close to the road, and it's kind of in this area where fire's never gotten close to there. And this day, August 18th, there were two other fires, and they're all in Napa, which is west of us, and they're huge, unbelievably huge fires caused by this big lightning storm that hit San Francisco and the Bay Area. There was a lot of smoke. The smoke was all over Northern California, but it was very prevalent in the area that I was in. We're thinking, you know, if another fire starts, we're screwed, because all the other firefighters are going and fighting that Napa fire, and they're not going to be able to get to ours. And so my mom was really, really smart about that, thinking ahead. And so we grabbed kind of like our most important things. We have a little box in our closet that says fire, that has super important documents and some pictures that are really important. We throw in cars, and we have a lot of cars. My dad is a mechanic, and so that's kind of his thing. And so we would get those out and just fill them up with important things that we could not bear to lose to a fire, and we'd move them all to the police station in downtown Winters. So we got a few things down there, but we weren't really thinking too much. Like, it's just another fire, you know. For those of you watching that are like thinking a fire is that scary, and it is, but for us, you know, it just happens so often that, you know, we didn't think anything would happen. And so hours passed by. I went to work, and I came back, and you know, the air was just so nasty, disgusting. I guess there was another fire that started over by Lake Berryessa, about 5 minutes from my house. And then we started kind of worry a little bit, but we talked to our neighbors, and around 11 o'clock, like PM, they weren't worried about it at all. I guess one of them talked to one of the firemen, and he said, don't worry about it, like it's pretty far away, and we got it under control. My little brother Michael, he gets a little scared of these fires, which is totally understandable. And so my dad took him and my other little brother Patrick to my grandma's house right here. And he was thinking, you know what, I'm just gonna drop him off, come back, takes about 2 hours round trip, and then he's gonna grab his classic cars in his garage and some of the dirt bikes, load those up, if the fire even comes, which we didn't think it was gonna come. I go to bed around 11:30. Everybody's gone. It's just myself and my mom. And I'm laying there for like 10 minutes. And all of a sudden, I just hear this megaphone. Somebody's screaming into the megaphone. And they're like, you guys gotta get out right now. Like, there's a fire. You guys gotta leave right this second. And I jump out of bed. And I run outside. And sure enough, over on this hill, there's a fire. Like, 15 feet, 10 feet high, just like dominoes rushing down the side of this hill, and it's going towards my neighbor's house. And I see it catch the back of my neighbor's property, like their actual house, and it starts going up in flames. And I'm like, I'm just so scared, and the adrenaline is running so high. It is so scary. And I mean, I just can't even feel for what the neighbors were feeling like, because theirs came faster, and it was all because the wind picked up. The wind picked up and tossed the fire in the other direction. It was wraps from there. And I'm like, I run back inside and I scream like, Mom, we gotta go. The fire is right on the other side of the hill. And it's coming from all three sides. Like, and it's just coming and coming. Like, it is rushing towards us. And my mom's in the shower and she had to get out, you know, grab some clothes, grab the dog, and literally just run up to the garage and get in one of the two classic cars. And this one is a 56 Suburban. It's really awesome. She hopped in there with the dog. I hopped in my Lexus, and I haven't packed up yet. I literally just ran to my closet, you know, grabbed a ton of clothes with my hands, tossed them in the car, and I didn't really think about the other stuff. You know, I have my important computer and hard drives and stuff that are my life. I grabbed those because that's important. But, you know, we lost everything. I'm turn on the car and just rush down, you know, and the fire is, it's on the backside of our garage. You can't even breathe. Like, it was so scary. I mean, I just remember, you know, driving super fast down the hill, adrenaline just pumping. And I guess my mom wanted to grab something else. And I'm at the bottom of the hill, down by the street. And I'm thinking, like, she's not coming. Like, 2 minutes passed and I'm just freaking out. Like, Mom, you gotta get out of there, because I can see the fire coming down from the hill. And it's reached the garage where she's at. And I guess she wanted to grab, like, a safe or something that had a lot of important, you know, money. But, and she comes rushing down. And I'm just totally relieved. And at that point, it was all just like, I'm just happy I have my family. And we drive down the road, and you know, it's just like the Paradise Fires, you know, it's on both sides and there's embers flying across the road, and you look back and your house is on fire. My physical childhood that I lived at for 18 years is just, it's up in flames. And my neighbor's house, you know, way before that, was just in an inferno. It was just gone. It was the saddest day of my life. So I mean, that's kind of what happened, and it's tough. It's really tough, but I'm just happy to be alive with my family, and you know, things are only gonna get better. So we've been looking at new houses lately, and it's so exciting, but it's also, you know, so sad, because we're never gonna have a log cabin ever again. You know, it's illegal to make one. We're gonna lose that forever, and we're gonna lose my dad's 55 Chevy pickup that was restored and so sick. But you know, it's time to move on. It's a new era, new beginnings. I've had a month to really think about it, and that's kind of how I feel about it. We're gonna have a house soon. Things are gonna get back to normal with coronavirus, and I'm gonna be able to go back to school, you know, make daily vlogs, and I can't wait for all that. But for now, I'm just happy to be on this earth. At the end of this video, I just want to throw in like a 3-minute montage of some of the clips that have happened there, and because some of the best memories have happened at that house. And you know, that's really the only thing that we can look back on, and it's more so for me, not as much for you guys, but you know, you might enjoy watching it. And yeah, so thank you for watching this video, and just know that I'm gonna be coming back stronger than ever. You know, I feel good about the future, so thank you. Peace.
Decide that the things that I tried were in my life just to get high on. When when I sit alone, come get a little known, but I need more than myself this time. Step from the road to the sea to the sky, and I do believe that we rely on. When I lay it on, come get to play it on, all my life to sacrifice. Hey, yo, listen what I say, yo. I got your hey, yo. Now listen what I say, yo. When will I know that I really can go to the well once more, time to decide on? When it's killing me, when will I really see all that I need to look inside? Come to believe that I better not leave before I get my chance to ride. When it's killing me, what do I really need? All that I need to look inside. Hey, oh, listen what I say, oh. Come back and hey, oh, look at what I say, oh. The more I see, the less I know, the more I like to let it go. The channels that